us and let her suck.
What?
Malgudi is the loveliest cup.
Swami, slept well.
Yes.
Where are you going?
Cricket practice. There's a test match tomorrow. MCC versus Board High School.
Really? Which team are you playing for?
How many times should I tell you? I am the vice captain of MCC, Malgudi Cricket Club, and also the opening bowler. My teammates call me Tate.
Tate?
Yes. He's a very famous English fast bowler.
Does that mean you won't go to school today?
I will go after practice.
Have your breakfast and go.
Not today, I am already late.
Swami, you run around all day long. Where do you get the energy from?
From the almond pudding you give me every day.
Hey, hey, sit and have your breakfast.
Money, cricket.
Sit down.
Swami, don't make a noise while eating. Listen to this newspaper article. An 8-year-old boy from the Memphis Hills survived an attack by a man-eating tiger. The boy climbed up the nearest tree and coolly threw sticks at it from the safety of the tree. The tiger, however, did not give up and guarded his prey till the early hours of the morning. Some villagers passing that way fell upon that animal and killed it. The young hero is now back with his family and is being given a certificate for bravery by the district collector. What do you have to say to such courage, young man?
He must have been very strong, very tall, and a very grown-up person, not a boy like me. Ma, how can a boy fight a tiger?
Oh, so you think you are wiser than the newspapers? Well, I say that a courageous person, even a boy, can do wonders. A man may have the strength of an elephant and yet be a coward, whereas another could have the strength of a small boy and fight tigers without blinking an eye. It is a question of whether you have it in you or not.
How can it be, Father? Suppose I have all the courage in the world. What can I do if a tiger should attack me?
Courage? Can you prove that you have even a little courage in you?
Oh, yes.
Are you prepared to show it?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes, sure.
Then can you sleep in my office room all alone from tonight?
Yes. Office?
Yes.
Alone?
Yes.
Tonight?
Yes. And that is settled.
Swami, why are you still here? No school today?
I will go. You know, Ma, we are going to admit even elder boys in our cricket club from now on. Father, we are going to buy brand new bats, balls and stumps. Our captain says he will be grateful if you give us some money.
Yes, we will see about all that later. Have you seen this place properly? From now on, you must sleep here alone.
I will. I will sleep alone, Father. I promise you. From the first of next month.
No, from tonight. Understand?
Have you done your homework today? Hello, Swami. What?
Now listen carefully. This is the place, Calcutta, where the British first entered India. In the year 1600, December 31st,
And this is also the place where the British established their first East India Company. And among the first battles to be fought against India was the Battle of Plassey in the year 1757. Swaminathan?
Yes, sir.
Where did the British first enter India?
Malgudi, sir.
Silence! Silence! Stand up on the bench. Up! Now pay attention here. This is the place, Calcutta, where the British first entered India.
Go to the town hall and burn their caps.
Come on, let's play. Hey, ball! Six!
Mani, we know that you can hit. Why make us run so much?
Come on, go fetch the ball. Banyan tree. Do you know what happened to Munswami's father last night?
What happened?
He was doing something strange under that banyan tree. The ghost came out and slapped him. And he spat out blood.
That ghost? Oh my God. When?
Last night at 2:30. That ghost would have come in front of me. I would have lifted my bat and hit him for a sixer.
Mani. It's rather late now. It's getting dark. Let's go home.
Come, come.
Okay, madam. I'll look for him.
Oh my God. What happened? My father is making me sleep in his office room from tonight. All alone. All alone. What will you do now? I don't know. Go to sleep before he comes home.
Just sneak off when he's reading the newspaper. Swami, do you know something? This is the same tree under which Munswami's father was slapped by the ghost. Swami, come inside.
Mani, see you tomorrow.
See you.
Is it any time to come home? Where were you?
Munswami.
Munswami?
Cricket.
Cricket?
Office.
Office?
Come on now. Wash up, say your prayers. But he's too young.
Nonsense. He must do it now. It is disgraceful sleeping beside mother or you like a baby sucking his thumb. He's not a child anymore. He is 9 years old and in the fifth form.
It's high time he started sleeping alone. You have spoiled him, the two of you.
Then, why do you look at me? If you mean your mother spoiling the boy, tell her so. I can do nothing about it.
Swami. Oh, Swami. Feeling sleepy? Don't you want a story tonight? Don't cover your face, my child, or else you'll suffocate.
Granny, silence!
Shall I put out the light?
Granny, keep quiet! Don't talk to me!
Are you angry with me, child?
Granny, please listen to me. Don't wake me up, even if the house is on fire. Understand? If I don't sleep at once, I shall perhaps die.
All right, all right. Go to sleep.
Come, dinner's ready.
Where is Swami?
He's had his dinner. He must be asleep.
Asleep? I told him to. Swami? Where are you, Swami? Oh, Swami. Come on, get up.
Sinu, why are you disturbing him? Let him be. He's fast asleep.
When I say something, I mean it. This has gone on for too long. All you do is spoil him. Come on, get up.
Granny!
Sinu, but where will he sleep?
In the office room.
Office?
Yes. 8-year-old boys are fighting tigers in the jungles. But my son, he sleeps with his story-telling grandmother. Come on,
Granny,
let's go.
Granny! 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 Mom,
why do you force him to sleep in the office room? Will he show any less courage by sleeping alone in the hall?
I said he's going to sleep in the office room tonight. And that's final.
Ma! Come. Granny! Please, Father, let me sleep in the hall. The office is very dusty. And God knows what snakes and scorpions are lying behind your books.
No, my son. There are no scorpions or snakes here. If you want, I will open the window. Here you are. You will get a nice cool breeze at night. And this is your bed for the day. If you want, you can sleep on this bench. Good night.
Father. Father, can I have a small light on?
What is there to be afraid of, Swami? We are just down the passage from you.
Father, will you please leave the door open?
All right. Promise you won't roll up your bed and go back to your granny.
Mm-hmm.
Mind you, if you do it, I will inform Mani and all your friends. Then, my boy, you will become the laughing stock of your school. Understand? Go to bed now.
I hate my father. I hate this office. Why should that newspaper have to write about that boy? Boy, monster more likely. A boy escapes from a tiger, and I have to spend the night here. I wonder if I'll wake up alive in the morning. It will serve Father right if he doesn't see me again.
Thank you. Swami! Run, Swami! Srinivasan!
Swami!
Get the police, someone!
Are you all right? Did he hurt you?
What happened?
I don't know anything. I don't know anything.
No.
And my son bit him and held on to his leg till we came.
Incredible. Mr. Srinivas, this is absolutely unbelievable.
Yes, indeed, sir. Incredible.
I do not understand how this young boy had the strength and courage to catch such a well-known thief. Come, son.
Well, sir, I suppose it was all my fault in making him sleep in my office room all alone. The window was left open. That's how the thief entered the house.
But whatever it is, it's a very brave thing that he did. Well, my boy, the police force needs young lads like you. Will you join the police force? It's a noble profession, in spite of what people say about it.
Today, my dear boys, the mission school is pleased to inform you of an extremely daring feat performed by one of its students last night, who in fact is now at the police station. And that boy is Swaminathan, studying in the fifth form. I would advise all boys present here to be as brave and courageous as Swami, and thus serve and liberate our country. And now for the prayers.
It was 3 o'clock in the night. 3 o'clock. Then at 3:30, the robber came in. I caught him, kicked him, put my hands together and bashed him hard. As soon as I hit him, he fell at the far end of the room. I jumped on him, twisted his hands and held him by his collar. The police inspector has asked me to join the force.
And when are you going to join? Tomorrow.
Swami, how did you manage to hold him down till your father came?
I caught him, bashed him hard on his face again and held him down. Yes, he threatened to break down the house, but I didn't let him go.
Really? Your father said something about biting the thief.
Biting? I don't bite. I am not such a coward.
Of course not. You are a brave boy. They say you are going to join the police force?
I don't know. I always wanted to become an engine driver or bus conductor. Now I'll have to think about
Listen, Swami. Don't take up all these dangerous jobs. Study well and take up a job in the government service. Under Secretary Chavi.
Granny, do you know that they are going to photograph me today? Why don't you come along?
Oh, me? Oh, no. I'm not supposed to get myself photographed. You go. Say your prayers, wear a smart dress, and go. Swami, don't go too close to the photo machine. They say it spits fire.
Sit straight. Chin up. Stomach in, chest out. Hold your breath. Come on, child, smile.
Who's that? Who is it?
It's me, the cook. What are you doing there?
You have to photograph me too.
Why?
Because it's me who held a thief.
Come here. Now you just hold this.
Will my photograph appear then?
Yes, on the reverse side. ready? Smile! Fire! Malgudi! Malgudi!
Swami! Where is Swami? Has he come back from cricket? He has hit the headlines in today's newspapers.
How nice he looks, see?
Yes, of course. But before that, I must show it to all my friends in the club.
Has my photograph appeared too?
No. Where is Swami?
He's asleep.
Asleep? Already? At this hour?
Yes. Like all boys of his age should be. He hasn't slept for 2 days now.
And that was thanks to you and your wonderful idea. Let him sleep in the office.
Yes, that's right.
So what is the solution? Put him next to you and let him suck his thumb? Be told stories for the rest of his life? You women are making a girl out of him. Braid his hair and send him to a girls' high school from tomorrow.
Why are you after him? Let him sleep where he likes.
Yes. There is no need to risk his life again by making him sleep in the office room. Look, Sinu, I want to tell you just one thing. I have got only one grandson. If anything happens to him...
Spoil him, both of you. When he grows up and becomes a spineless coward, don't blame me. That's all I have to say.
Swami, I'm going to tell you a new story tonight. The story of King Harishchandra. Once upon a time...
Granny!